Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for August the 30th of 2020, well, it is titled NGC 6357, Cathedral to Massive Stars. So what do we see here? Well, this is a star forming region, and we see some of the gas down below where stars are still in the process of formation. And up above, we see a grouping of stars that have recently formed. And in fact, one of these includes one of the more massive stars known to exist, and that is the part of the cluster known as Pismes 24. Now, the first star of these, the brightest one in that cluster, is actually not just a single star. And in fact, more recent observations have shown that it's actually probably about three stars very close together. And the single star originally thought to have been more than 200 times the mass of our sun is actually several stars, which would then be close to 100 times the sun's mass each. And that makes them about the largest stars currently theoretically possible based on our understanding of how stars work. Now, why would there be a limit to how massive a star can be? Well, the more massive a star, the hotter it gets in its core. And the hotter the core becomes, the more rapidly the nuclear reactions go and the more energetic it becomes. So it's producing more and more energy, and that energy pushes outward. And that is generally balanced by gravity pushing inward. So most stars will reach a stability like our sun, where the amount of energy being produced and the force pushing outward by that is exactly balanced by the gravitational force pushing downward. And as we see and have studied with various models, there's actually a limit to the point where the energy being produced from inside will actually start to push the material away. So to keep the star from growing any larger, the intense radiation pressure from the massive star will keep more material from adding to the star and will give us an upper limit to its mass, which is around 100 times the mass of our sun. So these are about some of the most massive stars that we believe can currently exist within the universe. Now, as we see more star formation going on, as we look further down, we see these stars up at top have already emerged from the cocoons. However, there are stars still forming down below. So within the gas and dust that we see towards the bottom of this image, more stars are continuing to form and may be forming very large stars. And we will see as they slowly move out of their cocoons over many thousands and hundreds of thousands of years, we'll get to see what new stars begin to form here. So that was our picture of the day for August the 30th of 2020. It was titled NGC 6357, Cathedral to Massive Stars. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Microquasar Imagined. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.